What's up, everyone? Mark Lobliner, TigerFitness.com, alongside
Steve Shaw, editorial director at TigerFitness.com, getting in my gains.
Some ISO, isn't it?
Yep, ISO.
What, that's not,
you, it's my third jug of ISO. I can't stop drinking this.
Do
stuff.
You even eat food anymore?
No.
No, that isolate's so good. But anyway,
I only eat two things, but we won't talk about the second.
I thought three things, but they're right next door to each other. Yeah. Anyway, check it out, guys. We get a lot of people who are opposite of me, who have really strong arms, really big arms, and cannot develop their chest. And I just wanted to give you a little tip. Just the tip. That was awesome. I wanted to give you a tip about something that I've found works for a lot of clients. And there's a lot of thoughts into when you should do a power movement and if you should pre-exhaust. There's a principle brought through by Joe Weider back with the Weider principle, which is the pre-exhaust principle. It's, for example, if you're trying to exhaust your quads or get the most out of your quads during leg day, what you would do is do leg extensions before squats, do a lot of them. That when you get to squats, your quads are fatigued. So while you're still going to recruit a lot of hamstring and glute, your quads are going to get extra, you know, work because their load is so heavy. So when you go heavy on squats, they're fatigued and you're overloading the muscle that much more. Apply that principle to chest. What I found works is either a pec deck or a dumbbell fly. Do that before you do a bench press. The reason being is that your pecs will be pre-exhausted, so you'll be able to stimulate it, overload it much easier than if you were to start out, and your arms, while they will be taking over, your chest will already be pre-exhausted, thus leading to more overload. Steve, what's your opinion on that?
Well, Mark, I am a guy who has like naturally big triceps. Like if there is a tricep dominant presser, it is me. My triceps, out of birth, they barely.
He has veins on his triceps, and I mean, I'm not saying it, but you're not exactly lean enough to have veins on your triceps, right?
Right.
Now.
It's just.
But
like,
he does. I'm looking at him right now. He has veins on his triceps.
And when I trained for 20 years doing the bodybuilding thing before I got into powerlifting, and I was always tricep dominant. So a lot of people dismiss pre-exhaust as like overthinking, but from someone like me who is completely tricep dominant in the pressing, I've had to make, back in the day, I had to make adjustments just to feel the chest. And one of my favorite ways to do it is what we were just talking about. I would do incline dumbbell flies. I didn't have access to a pec deck, so I do cable crossovers as pre-exhaust. But I always found just getting that nice squeeze in, just being able to connect with the chest before I moved on to the bench press was an excellent way to start a chest workout.
You know, and it applies to other exercises. If you're looking for a good movement, for example, before doing shoulder press, you have side laterals. Before doing any kind of straight leg deadlifts, you got hamstring curls. Before, I mean, Dorian used to always pre-exhaust with pullovers before he did his heavy back movements. And that's the way to pre-exhaust because of all the lat activation. And that's what he did. So one good routine for chest, if you have a weak chest in relation to your arms or your triceps, would be to start out with 3 to 4 sets of a fly or a pec deck. That'll warm you up, that'll get your muscles nice and warm, get your mind muscle into play. You know, 8 to 15 reps, start on the higher range as you warm up, pyramid down, and wait, and then move on and do your heavy stuff, either dumbbell bench press or flat bench press, and then do your exercises as you would. In fact, for someone with a really, really underdeveloped chest as opposed to their arms, I wouldn't be opposed to them doing fly first, then a pressing movement like a barbell or a dumbbell bench press, then another fly movement, and then a couple more presses for a total of 4 to 5 total chest movements. And I found that to really help people out who have that chest weakness.
If I could, Mark, I've been trying to focus more on my, I want to give you guys a sample routine that I've been doing lately. I've been trying to focus more on my chest strength to build up my bench press, and it's actually been working, my chest size and my chest strength. I will, when I'm doing the chest work, I'll do dumbbell flies. Excuse me. Ooh, that ISO's coming.
Why fart and waste it if you can burp and taste it?
Okay, so I'll start off with incline dumbbell flies after I do my bench work. Because I'm a power lifter, I'm training for a meet, so I'll do the big heavy bench work first. But then I'll really focus on the chest. What I'll do is incline dumbbell flies, and I do a superset afterwards. And this is an exercise a lot of guys don't do. It's the guillotine press. Now, you can't bring that bar down your neck because you're going to torque your shoulders. But when you do it, I can feel a really good quality chest stretch. and I just hold it in that position and I can just feel that contraction. I superset that with kind of slow push-ups just to feel the chest. So that's one of the ways I've been targeting chest. I've been leading off with incline dumbbell flies and doing that superset with guillotine presses and slower push-ups.
Yeah, and that's the key. I mean, the key is just working on things to help. So if you do have underdeveloped areas, be sure to pre-exhaust them or give it a try. I know some people are going to be like, oh no, that's stupid. You want to overload with the most weight as possible. What I've found, especially when you get older and you start, you know, getting injured and stuff, which you know, you do, the more weight you have, the more chance of injury you have. So what I've found is that doing a pre-exhaust type movement before that heavy compound, if powerlifting is not your focus, I've found that I will get more, if not just as much, if not more stimulation without as high of a risk of injury. Plus you have the added value of being extra warmed up. And if you keep potentially your form, your chance of injury, I find, just from a common sense standpoint and also from a getting injured standpoint, will be a lot less.
Yeah, you know, a lot. One of the things I talk to guys a lot about that are intermediate lifters is non-linear periodization, like not training heavy every week. So guys will ask me, well, what does that mean? Well, you could do, like, if you're really into heavy benching, you could do heavy benching 1 week. And then the next week, you could periodize by doing like some pre-exhaust work, like pre-exhaust your bench with flies, stuff like that. Just so when you pre-exhaust with flies, you're not going to be as strong as a bench. It's not as intense. So it's going to reduce the overall, you know, pressure on the joints and stuff like that. But you're still going to get in a great workout.
And so that's it, guys. We appreciate you watching. Again, for more updates and tips, again, go to our content site. He's the editorial director. content.tigerfitness.com or go to tigerfitness.com and click on the articles tab. Appreciate you watching, guys. I'm Mark Lobo and I'm my boy Steve Shaw.
Editorial director at tigerfitness.com.
Because pre-exhausting and not snapping your shit up, it's not a game.